Well, I know we're a little behind, but that's mainly because President Xi had, and I had a very constructive conversation. On a whole range of strategic issues. From North Korea to cyberspace to international institutions. And I'm very much looking forward to continuing the conversation, not only tonight at dinner, but also tomorrow.
非常期待着继续我们的讨论，不仅是今天晚餐的时候，还有明天。
But I thought we'd take a quick break just to take a question from both the U.S. and Chinese press.
但是我想简单借此机会来回答来自中国记者和美国记者的各一个问题。
So what I'll do is I'll start with Julie Pace, and then President Xi can call on a Chinese counterpart.
我先请 Julie Pace 发问，然后请习主席来。
Thank you, Mr. President. How damaging has Chinese cyber hacking been to the U.S., and did you warn your counterpart about any specific consequences if those actions continue? And also, while there are obviously differences between China's alleged actions and your government's surveillance programs, do you think that the new NSA revelations undermine your position on these issues at all during these talks? And President Xi,
why don't you let the interpreter?
在中国的这些黑美国的破坏的有多大，有没有警告有关方面，假如这种行为继续的话，会带来什么样的具体的后果呢？另外，对中国的声称的有这些骇客行动，它是和美国政府声称的最近这些监督的行为是有所不同的。但是最近关于美国国家安全局的这些声称的监督行为，有没有损害您在这个问题上的立场？
President Xi, did you acknowledge in your talks with President Obama that China has been launching cyber attacks against the U.S.? Do you also believe that the U.S. is launching similar attacks against China? And if so, can you tell us what any of the targets may have been? Thank you.
你有没有这个承认中国对美国发动这个网络袭击？那么是不是认为美国对中国也是正在发动类似的一些网络的袭击？有没有具体提到有关它的目标可能是什么？
Well, Julie, first of all, we haven't had yet in-depth discussions about the cybersecurity issue. We're speaking at the 40,000-foot level, and we'll have more intensive discussions during this evening's dinner.
首先, Julie, 我们还没有很深入地讨论有关网络安全这个问题。我们谈话的层次好像是 40,000英尺的高度, 那么到了一个晚餐的时候,我们会更具体地谈。
What both President Xi and I recognized is that because of these incredible advances in technology, that the issue of cybersecurity and the need for rules and common approaches to cybersecurity are going to be increasingly important as part of bilateral relationships and multilateral relationships.
习主席和我一直认识到的事情，也就是这个技术方面的迅速发展的话，那么将来网络安全的问题和对有关的规则的需要，会啊，也包括大家对网络安全问题采取共同的对待方法，将变得越来越重要，而且它越来越多会成为双边关系和多边关系的重要内容。
In some ways, these are uncharted waters, and you don't have the kinds of protocols that have governed military issues, for example, and arms issues, where nations have a lot of experience in trying to negotiate what's acceptable and what's not.
从很多方面来讲，这是一个新的领域，不像一些军事问题和武器问题，国家已经有很多经验可以通过谈判来判定什么是可接受，什么是不能够接受的。
And it's critical as two of the largest economies and military powers in the world, that China and the United States arrives at a firm understanding of how we work together on these issues.
至关重要的是，作为最大的两个经济体和军事强国，美中两国必须要在如何在这些问题上进行合作，达成非常清楚的了解。
But I think it's important, Julie, to get to the second part of your question, to distinguish between the deep concerns we have as a government around theft of intellectual property or hacking into systems that might disrupt those systems, whether it's our financial systems, our critical infrastructure, and so forth, versus some of the issues that have been raised around NSA programs.
但是Julie很重要的是，就是第二部分的，你说要做一个区别，就是我们作为一个政府非常深切的关切，这个知识财产的盗窃问题和一些骇客行为可能会扰乱我们一些系统，包括金融方面和我们关键的技术设施方面的，这个是要区别开来，和最近围绕着这个NSA的一些安全问题是不同的。
When it comes to those cybersecurity issues like hacking or theft, those are not issues that are unique to the U.S.-China relationship. Those are issues that are of international concern. Oftentimes, it's non-state actors who are engaging in these issues as well. And we're going to have to work very hard to build a system of defenses and protections, both in the private sector and in the public sector, even as we negotiate with other countries around setting up a common rules of the road.
那么可是网络安全的问题，不管是骇客行为还是盗窃行为，这不只是美中关系所独有的一个问题，实际上是国际上所关切的一个问题，而经常是一些非国家的行动方在做的一些事情，所以我们必须要做非常艰苦的努力来建立起一个体制，来保护和防卫我们的包括私人部门和公有部门，而同时和其他国家进行谈判，来达成一些共同要遵守的规则。
And as China continues in its development process and more of its economy is based on research and innovation and entrepreneurship, they're going to have similar concerns.
随着中国的经济的不断发展，它的经济越来越多会建立在研究创新和企业精神的基础之上，它也会有类似的关切。
Which is why I believe we can work together on this rather than at cross purposes.
这就是为什么我认为我们在这个问题上是可以共同努力，而不是相反的目标。
Now, the NSA program, as I discussed this morning, is a very limited issue, but it does have broad implications for our society because you've got a lot of data out there, a lot of communications that are in cyberspace, and how we deal with both identifying potential terrorists or criminals, how the private sector deals with potential theft, and how the federal government, state governments, local governments, and private sector coordinate to keep out some of these malicious forces while still preserving the openness and the incredible power of the internet and the web and these new telecommunication systems. That's a complicated and important piece of business, but it's different from these issues of theft and hacking.
那么这个像我所说的，今天早上他们提到 NSA 这个问题是有局限性的，当然它对我们社会也有广泛的一个影响，因为有大量的数据和这个通信是通过网络空间的，所以我们如何处理这些问题，比如说要识别出来一些可能的潜在的恐怖主义者或者犯罪者呢？同时这个私营部门怎么样保护自己不受到这个盗窃的这个影响？ 还有联邦州政府、地方政府，还有私有部门，怎么样有效的进行协调，来防止这些这个恶劣的势力的这些影响呢？而同时保护我们开放的、强大的这个因特网、互联网的、外围网的这个机制，这是非常重要的问题。但是这是不同于刚才说的这个骇客行为的问题，这个盗窃行为是另外一个事情。
And every government is inevitably going to be involved in these issues, just like big companies are going to be involved in these issues. I mean, you know, you've got private companies that have a lot more data and a lot more details about people's emails and telephone calls than the federal government does. And if we're called upon to not only to make sure that we're anticipating terrorist communications, but we're also called upon to work with the private sector to prevent theft out of ATMs, et cetera, then we're going to have to find ways to deal with this big data in ways that are consistent with our values, in ways that protect people's privacy, that ensure oversight, and strike the right balance. As I indicated this morning, that's a conversation that I welcome having.
那么不可避免的，所有的政府都会被牵涉到这个事情，都是要参与。也会影响到一些大的企业呢，因为实际上这些私有企业，他们所拥有的一些数据和详细的细节，有关一些人的电子邮件和其他的一些通信的内容，可能比联邦政府还要多呢。所以一方面要求我们来，防止可能出现的一些恐怖主义的一些行为，而同时要保护私人部门的这些隐私权，还有包括自动取款机的，防止它被盗窃的一些问题。那么，而同时要符合我们的一些价值观，保护人们的隐私，还有有效的监督。关键是要有一个适当的一个平衡。正如我今天早上所说的，我欢迎人们来讨论这个问题。
正像奥巴马总统先生讲到的，我们就网络安全问题的探讨啊，在第一轮会晤的时候只是刚刚的设计。那么，中国政府呢，是网络安全的坚定维护者，也对网络安全呢持有重大的关切。
As President Obama said in our meeting this afternoon, we just briefly touched upon the issue of cybersecurity. And the Chinese government is firm in upholding cybersecurity, and we have major concerns about cybersecurity.
在我与奥巴马总统这一次元首会晤之前的几天，我也关注到媒体上，对于这个 网络安全问题的关注度陡然提高，这方面的信息很大，这个似乎给人一种感觉，就是这个网络安全的威胁主要来自于中国，或者说呢，中美之间的最突出的问题就是这个问题。
And a few days before President Obama and I meet today, I note a sharply increased media coverage of the issue of cybersecurity. This might give people the sense or feeling that cybersecurity as a threat mainly comes from China, or that the issue of cybersecurity is the biggest problem in the China-US relationship.
新技术的应用可以说是 一把双刃剑，既推动了人类的物质文化生活的进步，同时也带来了一些管理上的问题，对于这个无论是国家、企业、社会、个人的一些带来的一些这个权利的危害，这方面确实存在着这种情况。
The application of new technology is a double-edged sword. On the one hand, it will drive progress in ensuring better material and cultural life for the people. On the other hand, it might create some problems for regulators, and it might infringe upon the rights of states, enterprises, societies, and individuals.
我们要确实高度关注这个事情。 并且研究如何有效地加以解决，这也正是中美我们在务实合作中需要加以这个合作的一个方面。我也高兴地 了解到呢，我们已经商定，在中美战略与经济对话机制下，专门设一个中美关于网络安全问题的工作小组。我们所以说明中美正在加紧研究这个问题。
We need to pay close attention to this issue and study ways to effectively resolve this issue. And this matter can actually be an area for China and the United States to work together with each other in a pragmatic way. And I'm happy to learn that within the context of the China-US Strategic and Economic Dialogue, a working group has been established to discuss cybersecurity issues.So this is an issue that the two sides will continue to discuss.
我想呢，我们，通过一种真诚的合作，消除猜疑，反而可以使啊，中美在信息安全领域啊，网络安全领域啊，成为我们今后加强中美关系的一个亮点。
By conducting good faith cooperation, we can remove misgivings and make information security and cybersecurity a positive area of cooperation between China and the U.S.
因为这是我们共同的需求和关切，中国呢也是网络安全方面的一个受害者，我们也希望呢切实解决这个问题。谢谢。
Because China and the United States both have a need.And both share a concern. And China is a victim of cyber attacks. And we hope that earnest measures can be taken to resolve this matter. Thank you.
我问奥巴马总统的问题同样有关于新型大国关系，就您认为美国方面将如何为构建中美的这种新型大国关系做出努力？谢谢。
I'm with China Central Television, and my question for President Xi is, what are the main issues that were discussed in the longer than expected meeting this afternoon? And what are the major areas of consensus that have emerged from the discussion?And last year, when you were visiting the United States, you raised the concept of the two sides working together to explore what you call a new model of major country relationship, something that is unprecedented in the relationship and that can inspire future generations. And after this concept was raised, there has been much discussion and comment on it, both in China and the United States and in the world more broadly. So,did you have further discussion on this issue in your meeting this afternoon? And my question for President Obama is, what will the United States do to contribute to the building of a new model of major country relationship between China and the U.S.?
我和奥巴马总统进行了第一次会晤，我们就各自的内外政策建设新型大国关系，以及啊，我们共同关心的国际和地区问题，深入坦诚地交换了意见，并且呢，达成了一些重要的共识。
In the first meeting that I've had with President Obama this afternoon, we had in-depth, sincere, and candid discussion on.The domestic and foreign policies of China and the United States, on our joint work to build a new model of major country relationship, and on international and regional issues of mutual interest. And the President and I reached important consensus on these issues.
我向 奥巴马总统明确地表示，中国将坚定不移地走和平发展的道路，坚定不移地深化改革、扩大开放。我们要努力实现中华民族啊伟大复兴这个中国梦啊，也努力地去推进人类的和平与发展的崇高事业。
I stated very clearly to President Obama that China will be firmly committed to the path of peaceful development, and China will be firm in deepening reform and opening up the country wider to the world. China will work hard to realize the Chinese dream of the great national renewal and will work hard to push forward the noble cause of peace and development for all mankind.
中国梦呢就是国家富强、民族振兴、人民幸福，它也是合作、发展、和平、共赢的梦。这也和美国梦和各国人民的美好梦想啊是相通的。
By the Chinese dream, we seek to have economic prosperity, national renewal, and people's well-being. The Chinese dream is about cooperation, development, peace, and win. And it is connected to the American dream and the beautiful dreams people in other countries may have.
我和奥巴马总统啊，一致认为，在当前经济全球化和各国同舟共济这样一个客观的需求下，中美两国呢，一定要走出一条不同于以往大国之间啊必然对抗冲突的新路来。那么，这样的一条道路呢，我们认为是双方应该努力地建设新型大国关系，互相尊重，合作共赢，以造福于两国人民和世界人民。这也是国际是吧上的一种重要的关注啊，因为中美两国合作好了，这是世界稳定的压舱石，是世界和平的助推器。
President Obama and I both believe that in an age of economic globalization and facing the objective need of countries sticking together in the face of difficulties, China and the United States must find a new path, one that is different from the inevitable confrontation and conflict between the major countries of the past.And that is to say, the two sides must work together to build a new model of major country relationship based on mutual respect and win-win cooperation for the benefit of the Chinese and American peoples and people elsewhere in the world. The international community looks to China and the United States to deliver this. When China and the United States work together, we can be an anchor for world stability and a propellerOf world peace.
我愿意呢和奥巴马总统啊加强各层次的中美各层次的这种交往，我愿意和总统先生通过互访啊，通过会晤，通过通信通话保持啊密切的联系啊，我也邀请奥巴马总统适时的到中国去进行我们新一轮的会晤啊，并且我们啊展开正式的互访啊，同时我们要进一步推进啊战略与经济对话啊人文交流啊这个高层磋商这些机制的这个如期开展啊。今年呢，我们的外交部长和国防部长也要应邀访美。
I stand ready to work with President Obama to expand on all levels of exchanges between the two sides. I look forward to maintaining close communication with the President through mutual visits, bilateral meetings, exchange of letters, and phone calls. And I invite President Obama to come to China at an appropriate time. And we look forward to visiting each other's country. At the same time, the two sides will progress in the various bilateral mechanisms, such as the strategic and economic dialogue and the high-level consultation on people-to-people exchange. Also, the Chinese Minister of Foreign Affairs and the Chinese Minister of National Defense will both make visits to the United States within the year.
在宏观经济政策方面呢，加强调控的这种协调，在我们的各自发展中呢，加强合作，推动我们的经济的发展，世界亚太地区和世界的经济的强劲、可持续、平衡的发展。
Our two sides should also step up exchanges and cooperation in economy and trade, energy, environment, people-to-people, and cultural fields, as well as at the subnational level, so that we can deepen the shared interests of the two countries and expand them to all areas. We should also improve and strengthen the military-to-military relationship between the two countries and promote the building of a new model of military relationship between the two sides. The two sides should also improve coordination on macroeconomic policies so that by strengthening cooperation, we can contribute to our respective development at home and promote strong, sustainable, and balanced economic growth in the Asia-Pacific region and the world at large.
关于新兴大国关系的建设呢, 我是具有信心的, 这个事在人为。
And I'm confident in our joint effort to build a new model of major country relationship. I believe success hinges on the human effort.
第一，我们都有这方面的政治意愿。
Firstly, both sides have the political will to build this relationship.
第二呢，40年的中美合作的积累啊， 我们具有很好的这样的合作基础。
Secondly, our cooperation in the last 40 years provides a good foundation for us to build on.
第三个呢, 中美之间有90多个机制, 我们建立了机制的保障。
Thirdly, between China and the United States, there are over 90 intergovernmental mechanisms which provide the institutional underpinning for our efforts.
第四个呢, 就是我们民间的基础也很好。 现在呢，有220个地方的姊妹城市关系。同时呢，我们也有19万的中国学生在这里留学，有2万的美国留学生在中国留学。Fourth,
there is strong public support for this kind of relationship between China and the United States. There are 220 pairs of sister provinces, states, and cities between China and the U.S. There are 190,000 Chinese students in the United States and 20,000 American students in China.
第五个就是我们有广泛的未来的合作空间。
And fifth, there is enormous scope for future cooperation between China and the U.S.
当然这个事业呢是一个前无古人后起来者的事业，这需要我们就是不断的去增进了解，加强互信。 发展合作，管控分歧，来确实走出一条避免传统大国必然对抗这样的这个老路，而走出一条
Of course, this endeavor is unprecedented and one that will inspire future generations. So we need to deepen our mutual understanding, strengthen our mutual trust, further develop our cooperation, and manage our differences so that we can avoid the traditional path of inevitable confrontation between major countries and really embark on a new path.
中华民族和美利坚民族都是伟大的民族，我们两国人民都是伟大的民族，只要我们呢，能够啊，登高望远，也能够呢，积微成著，啊，从大处招眼，从小处招手，保持我们的信心和决心，保持我们的智慧和耐心，我相信啊，我们一定能够完成这样的一个
The Chinese nation and the American nation are great nations, and the Chinese people and the American people are great peoples. As long as we stand high and look far, as long as we make specific progress and accumulate them over time, as long as we maintain confidence and determination, as long as we have wisdom and patience, I'm confident that we will succeed in achieving this historical mission.
我讲得太长了，谢谢。
I'm sorry for going too long. Thank you.
Well, I think President Xi summarized very well the scope of our conversations.
我认为习主席讨论的范围。
We spoke about some very specific issues. For example, President Xi mentioned the importance of military-to-military communications. In the past, we've had high-level diplomatic communications about economic and strategic issues, but we haven't always had as effective communications between our militaries, and at a time when you know, there's so much activity around the world, it's very important that we each understand our strategic objectives at the military as well as the political levels. So that's an example of concrete progress that can advance this new model of relations between the United States and China.
我们也谈到了很多具体问题，比如说习主席提到了两军沟通的重要性。那么过去我们有过高层的外交方面的沟通，讨论经济问题、战略问题。 但是我们的两军之间的沟通并不总是这么有效的，所以在当世界上有这么多的事情的时候呢，我们非常需要了解各自的战略的目标，包括在军事层次，也包括在政治层次呢，所以这是一个可以取得具体进展的一个领域，我用来促进美中两国之间这种新型关系的一个模式。So
we'll be taking steps to institutionalize and regularize such discussions.
所以我们采取措施使这种讨论能够制度化，经常性的。
But more broadly, I think President Xi identified the essence of our discussions in which we shared our respective visions for our country's futures and agreed that we are more likely to achieve our objectives of prosperity and security of our people if we are working together cooperatively rather than engaged in conflict.
可是更广泛的来说，习主席也指出了我们讨论的主要的这个内容，就各自介绍了为各自国家未来的一些愿景。我们一致认为，我们假如能够进行很好的合作而不进行对抗的话，我们是更能够 实现我们人民繁荣和安全的目标。
And I emphasize my firm belief to President Xi that it is very much in the interest of the United States for China to continue its peaceful rise, because if China is successful, that helps to drive the world economy, and it puts China in a position to work with us as equal partners in dealing with many of the global challenges that no single nation can address by itself. So, for example, neither country by itself can deal with the challenge of climate change. That's an issue that we'll have to deal with together. China is the largest country. As it continues to develop, will be a larger and larger carbon emitter unless we find new mechanisms for green growth. The United States, we have the largest carbon footprint per capita in the world. We've got to bring down our carbon levels in order to accommodate continued growth. And so that will translate then into opportunities for specific work around green technologies and research and development and interactions between our scientists so that we can together help advance the goal of a sustainable planet even as we continue to grow and develop.
举个例子来说，这个气候变化没有任何一个国家能够单独的应对这个挑战。我们必须要合作才行。那么中国是这个大国，而且在继续发展，是一个最大的碳的排放方。而所以我们需要找出一些新的绿色增长的一些机制呢。那么美国呢，按照这个人均来算，是这个碳足迹是最大的，而且我们在继续的增长的时候，必须要减少这方面的排放。 所以这会给我们带来很多新的合作的机会，包括在绿色技术方面的研究和发展，而且让我们两国的科学家能够互动的，来促进这个一个可持续的星球的这个增长，这个最终的目标，而同时继续各自的经济发展。We've
got a lot of work to do to take these broad understandings down to the level of specifics, and that will require further discussions not only today and tomorrow, but for weeks, months, years to come.
所以要把这些比较广的一些谅解带到一些具体措施的层次的话呢，我们还有大量的工作要做，不仅仅是今天和明天的讨论，还要花好几周、好几个月、好几年的时间才能够做到。But
what I'm very encouraged about is that both President Xi and myself recognize we have a unique opportunity to take the U.S.-China relationship to a new level. I am absolutely committed to making sure that we don't miss that opportunity.
但是我们感到非常鼓舞的是，习主席和我们是绝对致力于利用这个机会，使美中关系发展到一个新的层次，而且我绝对是不要错过这个机会。Thank
you very much, everybody.
非常感谢大家。谢谢。
So what I'll do is I'll start with Julie Pace, and then President Xi can call on a Chinese counterpart.
先请 Julie Pace 发问，然后请习主席来，请中国记者提问。
Thank you, Mr. President. How damaging has Chinese cyber hacking been to the U.S., and did you warn your counterpart about any specific consequences if those actions continue? And also, while there are obviously differences between China's alleged actions and your government's surveillance programs, do you think that the new NSA revelations undermine your position on these issues at all during these talks? And President Xi,
在中国的这些黑美国的破坏力有多大？有没有警告有关方面？假如这种行为继续的话，会带来什么样的具体的后果呢？另外，对中国的声称的有这些骇客行动，它是和美国政府声称的最近这些监督的行为是有所不同的。但是最近关于美国国家安全局的这些声称的监督行为，有没有损害您在这个问题上的立场？
President Xi, did you acknowledge in your talks with President Obama that China has been launching cyber attacks against the U.S.? Do you also believe that the U.S. is launching similar attacks against China? And if so, can you tell us what any of the targets may have been? Thank you.
您有没有这个承认中国对美国发动这个网络袭击？那么是不是认为美国对中国也是正在发动类似的一些网络的袭击？有没有具体提到有关它的目标可能是什么？
Well, Julie, first of all, we haven't had yet in-depth discussions about the cybersecurity issue. We're speaking at the 40,000-foot level, and we'll have more intensive discussions during this evening's dinner.
首先，Julie，我们还没有很深入讨论有关网络安全这个问题。我们谈话的层次而起的重要内容。
In some ways, these are uncharted waters, and you don't have the kinds of protocols that have governed military issues, for example, and arms issues, where nations have a lot of experience in trying to negotiate what's acceptable and what's not.
从很多方面来讲，这是一个新的领域，不像一些军事问题和武器问题，国家已经有很多经验可以通过谈判来判定什么是可接受，什么是不能够接受的。
And it's critical as two of the largest economies and military powers in the world that China and the United States arrives at a firm understanding of how we work together on these issues.
至关重要的是，作为最大的两个经济体和军事强国，美中两国必须要在如何在这些问题上进行。
I know we're a little behind, but that's mainly because President Xi had, and I had a very constructive conversation.
我知道这一次花的时间比较长一点，但主要是因为习主席和我进行了非常有建设性的交谈。
On a whole range of strategic issues,
包括范围广泛的战略问题,
from North Korea to cyberspace to international institutions,
包括北朝鲜网络空间还有国际组织,
and I'm very much looking forward to continuing the conversation not only tonight at dinner but also tomorrow.
非常期待着继续我们的讨论，不仅是今天晚餐的时候，还有明天。
But I thought we'd take a quick break just to take a question from both the U.S. and Chinese press.
但是我想简单这次机会来回答来自好像是四万英尺的高度。那么到了这个晚餐的时候，我们会更具体的谈。
What both President Xi and I recognized is that because of these incredible advances in technology, that the issue of cybersecurity and the need for rules and common approaches to cybersecurity are going to be increasingly important as part of bilateral relationships and multilateral relationships.
习主席和我一直认识到的事情，也就是这个技术方面的迅速发展的话，那么将来网络安全的问题和对有关的规则的需要，会也包括大家对网络安全问题采取共同的对待方法，将变得越来越重要，而且它越来越多会成为双边关系和多边关系。